So sometimes you'll have patients that come in with their hair down and it's difficult to work around it. So it's always good to just ask them to place their hair back in a ponytail. So now that the patient has her ears unobstructed, we're going to go ahead and put on the bone oscillator. So if we're doing mastoid, what you want to do is you want to make sure that you put it behind the ear to where it's not touching the ear. So we're going to just place it on the mastoid bone like this. And then the front portion will just be like that. And we've got good placement because we're not touching the ear and we're still on the mastoid. So some people prefer to do bone conduction testing on the forehead. To place it on the forehead, you just put it in the middle of the forehead and make sure it's secure. And then your patient's ready to go. So now we're going to show you how to do masking for bone conduction. It's a little bit more tricky when you have headphones, so that's why we're going to use headphones instead of inserts for this. So we have the mastoid bone conductor on the right hand side, so that means we need to mask for the left ear. So when you go to put it on, you're going to put the left ear on the ear, and then you just want to place the right side somewhere to where it doesn't move your bone oscillator. So now we're going to show you how to place your audio cups for masking for bone conduction testing. So we have the bone oscillator on the right side. So that means we're going to want to put the left audio cup on the left ear. And then we also just want to make sure that the right audio cup hasn't moved our bone oscillator and that it's staying in place. Everything looks good. It's still not touching the ear, so she's all ready to go. The best way to do masking for bone conduction is with inserts. It's just the easiest method to use. So if you do have insert headphones, what you want to do first is make sure that you have a new pair of foam inserts, and you want to put it on. And when you're pressing down on the insert, you want to make sure that you press away from the hole so that the hole doesn't become occluded by the foam. So I'm going to go ahead and make it really small. I'm going to pull back on her ear and I'm going to place it into the canal. Now she's all ready to go for masking for the right side.